Hello there, and welcome back to the Booyah and Platinum and Saturday Nuzlocke. In the last episode, Cyrus, basically his plans almost succeeded. He released Dialga and Palkia and hoped to use their... Is there something over here? Or is it a dead end? It's a dead end. And hoped to use their powers to create a new world, but he failed because Giratina interfered. He didn't like that he was going to try to change the world. So, you know, it's very... I'm honestly a bit unfamiliar with the Sinnoh region stuff. So, really traveling downward. Just, I don't care what Cynthia says. I don't like her. I don't know if Giratina is evil. Because he gives off that impression as being, like, a dark shadow. Okay. Oh, this is cool. Yep. The Distortion World is a nice... It has a cool look to it, but I'm not a huge fan of what you actually do in it. It's all puzzles. Which aren't bad, but... I'd rather be doing, like, battles and stuff. But yeah, I don't know if Giratina is evil, because he's kind of the one who stopped Cyrus. So in a way, he's not evil, but... I just feel like he gives off that impression, being the Pokemon of the Distortion World and Shadows. And stuff. Is this a dead end? It is. That's another thing I don't like about this place. There are areas that they put in that are just floating blocks of rock. They go nowhere. And I understand the point, the purpose behind it. It's trying to show that this is just a world that's completely distorted. Hence the word distorted world. Distortion world. Why does it exist? Yeah, I'd like to know that part too. If it is explained somewhere, the story of Giratina and Dialga and Palkia and them, then I'm unaware of it. All I know is for sure is that, you know, Dialga controls time, Palkia controls space, and together they make sure the world is in balance. And Cyrus tried to ruin that by releasing them both and stuff like that. I hope I'm going the right way. I'm trying basically every way I can go. Oh, this does go left. And now I have to go all the way back around! Ugh. You just saw me do that, I'll skip that. Oh, wait a minute. Maybe not. No, not that! I don't like this place. I didn't mean to step there. Yeah, I don't know where the heck I'm going, guys. Ooh. Yep, I guess that was the right way. Oh, hey, Cyrus, what's up? Everyone isn't here. It abandoned me here. It was just meant to interfere with me. Do you understand the concept of genes? Yes. If it's true, you've impressed me. Genes can be considered the blueprints of all life forms. That includes humans and Pokemon alike. Genes are contained in a DNA strand. DNA strand of two chains, spiral. If one of those chains were to be broken, the other could replicate it. One or the other cannot exist without its opposite. Do you understand where I'm going with this? This is a bizarre world. Time doesn't flow. Space isn't stable. Only that shadow Pokemon lives here. This world is the opposite of our world. Our world I wish to change. It is like the two chains composing of a strand of DNA. The two worlds must be balancing each other to remain in existence. Without the one, the other cannot exist. The shadow Pokemon must play a role in keeping the worlds in balance. That is why it must have interfered and brought me here. The shadow Pokemon must have made this bizarre world. That's why trying to change our world disturbed it and made it reveal itself. But that's all irrelevant. What matters is defeating that Pokemon and making this world disappear. I won't allow it to interfere with me again. With it gone, neither world will be able to revert to its original state. Thank you, Cyrus. You just explained everything that I just asked the viewers a second ago. So, Giratina made the Distortion World simply to balance the worlds we already have and know. Because you need an opposite for something to work. Like DNA. And that makes complete sense now. So Giratina is not evil. He plays his role as well in keeping the world balanced. But honestly, guys, I am very unfamiliar with the Distortion World, so I could very well be going the complete wrong way, and I won't know it until I reach a huge dead end and have to go the other direction. And here's a ledge. Alright, Yuxi, what are you trying to tell me? Grab the rock and put it down there? Is that what you're saying? I hope it is, but that's what I'm gonna do. Come on, Majestic, push that boulder. Bye-bye. Alright, now, before I forget, I want to put Morton up front. Because, I'm glad that didn't work. I think Cyrus starts with Houndoom. I think. Is there something over here? Interesting. You can surf over here. Is there anything over here that's actually useful? I don't think there's any hidden items around here. Then what's the point of this? Oh yeah, decoration. See, that's why I feel like a lot of people really overhyped this world when it was, like, being talked about as a feature that Platinum would have as opposed to Diamond and Pearl. It's kind of just a eye candy. It's not really that special, in my personal opinion. Yes, hi, Masperit! I understand that you like me, but... Yeah. Basically, it's these puzzles that we basically have to do here. And the three fairy Pokemon help me along by telling me where I'm supposed to push the boulders. And yeah. I didn't want to go up, I want to go down. Where did that just take me? Oh, hey, Giratina. This part's cool, I have to admit. I just hope I'm going the right way. Now I'm going up again. But what about going down with the boulders? Yeah, I don't know where the heck I'm going, guys, so... Don't blame me. What is this way? Oh, that isn't a real way. Okay. How about this? Ooh! Let's see what down this way first. It's nothing. Cool. Now we're gonna go this way, down this way, and I feel like I've been here already. This place all looks the same. Yeah, I've been here already. Yeah, I know exactly where I am. I went in a complete circle. Oh my god. Yeah, I'm not a huge fan of this world at all, if you couldn't tell. Yeah, I don't understand the point of that. Is it just meant to be a giant puzzle slash maze? If it is, I can sort of understand how that would appeal to some people, but I don't know. It's not bad. I'm just not a huge fan of it. So yeah, we already did that part. There's nowhere else to go but this way. And then we did go down. Where did we go exactly? We went this way. That's the only way to go! Or is it? Or was there another way over there that I just chose not to go? See, this can get us to this area too. See, Cynthia's down there! Why can't I get down there? I can't fall down the holes myself. Maybe this is the right way to go, but I went the wrong way while I was up here. Can't go that way. Oh, come on. I'm just going in a giant circle, aren't I? Can I go this way? I can, but there's nothing there. Yeah, but this is going to send me back to where I was. I just was here. Unless I can go... Unless something's over here. No. Nothing. Yeah, I... That was the only way to go, though. Oh, what about right here? I don't know where I am, guys, so... This is just going to be me guessing where to go. Hope you don't mind. Oh, I haven't been here yet. It can't be possibly the wrong way. I guess it can, but... I guess it's hoping I have surf. I guess I really couldn't have gotten here if I didn't have surf, so... And there's Giratina again. Whee! I'm on the walls, now on the ceiling. And I'm gonna surf here. Oh, and that waterfall. Yeah, that's definitely the right way to go. This is so weird. Yeah, I'm going down. I'm going down a waterfall that is flowing up. Awesome. You know, I only pushed two boulders down. Wasn't there another one I'm supposed to push down with Azelf? Or is this the one with Azelf that I just got to right now? Oh, it is. Alright, I thought this was one that I already pushed down, but I guess clearly I'm wrong. So yeah, I found the right way to go. Apparently. Yes, Azelf, I get it! Push the boulder down the hole. And I have to activate strength again. That is quite alright. And that goes down there. And then it looks like the only way to go is back that way. So there must be a way to get down there that I'm unaware of. Oh, right here! I see it! There's a little notch here. Awesome. Alright, now what do I have to do? Push the boulders in the holes? Or... You know, I think I have to push the boulders in the holes that the fairies are sitting next to. Pew! Pew, pew, pew! Yeah, alright, and I have to push this one to down that one, not... Yeah. There we go. I understand. Pee! No, I didn't want to go that way. I want to go this way. And... Mesprit's way over there. Oh, no. Such a hard puzzle. I wonder I'm going to get this rock over there. Yay! Pee! Alright, well, all three of them got their boulders in the holes. And here's Cynthia. Do you have anything fun to say? They've gone home. They keep the balance. What about Giratina? No time for chit-chat. Oh, so I guess that appears after you do the boulder thingies. Let's do this. And if only Cynthia actually cares to help me during these battles, but... Oh, wait, there's Cyrus! Alright, guys, this might be it. The final battle against Cyrus. And this is not going to be fun, because Cyrus is very difficult. Here we go, guys. So, you were already here. Why do you seek to change the... Oh, that's Cynthia, sorry. Why do you seek to change the world? If you hate our world, just go off somewhere alone. Find somewhere you can live without seeing others. Why should I run and hide from this world? Wait. Their names look so similar. It's hard to keep track of who's talking. Why should I run and hide from this world and have to wait quietly? My aim is to rid the world of this the vague and incomplete thing we call spirit. By freeing ourselves of that, our world can be made complete. That is my justice. No one can interfere. Okay. Am I supposed to talk to him and battle him now or something? Oh, goody. Alright, here we go. I won't lose! Not to that shadow Pokemon! Not in any worthless world! Dun dun dun. The final battle against Cyrus. It's all sparkly everywhere. Houndoom, I was right, he does start with Houndoom. Morton! Show him how it's done! Surf! Oh, he goes first. That's not surprising. But, oh my god, oh my god! Okay, and I flinched. Wonderful! Wonderful. You guys have no idea how much that ruined this entire battle, just right there. Because now there is no way Morton can have full health with this thing. Look, a critical hit will kill me. But I have no choice. Will-O-Wisp. Oh, he didn't... Thank you! I do not mind being Will-O-Wisp because Morton has Surf as his primary attack. And I don't think there's any Pokemon he has that I would use Dig against anyway, so... Bye, Houndoom! One down, four to go! And... Morton's hurt by his burn. Gyarados! Oh, goody. All right, I want to switch into Archer, but Gyarados is really strong. So I feel like... Crap. Well, I'm not going to keep Morton in, I know that much. But who do I switch to? I feel like no matter who I switch to, it will end badly. What do I think he's going to use? I really hope he doesn't use Earthquake. That will kill Archer in one hit, and then I am screwed. Because I think he's the only one who can even stand a chance against Gyarados. And to top it off, I would have lost Archer. Well, guys, just in case I lose any of you today, I just have to say right now, you have been an amazing team so far, and I will... You guys have been amazing. Even if you die today, you have not let me down. Come on, Archer. Waterfall! Okay, I can live with that! Unless it's a critical hit or something. Okay, you know what? My only chance is to use Shockwave right now. It is my only chance. Because Gyarados, look at that. There is no way, even if I heal, he'll do the exact same amount of damage. Or kill me. Archer? This is all up to you, buddy! Oh, how I wish I had Thunderbolt. I would have so much more faith in Thunderbolt. No! No! Archer! No! And he's gonna heal, isn't he? Archer. Exxon? I have faith in you. Full restore. What is with Cyrus and killing my electric types? Please do more than half, please! Thank you. I know I- withdrew! No! You have got to be kidding me! You have got to be kidding me! Oh my god. What the hell do I do now? I would just say switch to Morton, he can handle anything. But he is burned and half dead. Oh my god, this is impossible. There is nothing I can do. Someone else is gonna have to die, apparently. Okay, I gotta think this through really hard. I need Morton. I need Morton to fight Honchkrow right now. Do I have a full restore? I have one full restore. That's got Morton's name written all over it. However, Honchkrow has Night Slash. He's gonna do a lot of damage to Exxon and possibly kill him if I keep him in. But if I switch out, that person will get hit with a Night Slash, and then while I'm healing Morton, that person will get hit with something else. Who do I feel like can resist all of Honchkrow's attacks? Hawes. But Hawes is not very defensive. Maybe Hawes can actually even fight Honchkrow himself. Let's go with Hawes. I don't know how the hell I'm gonna beat the Gyarados now. Night Slash, I was right. He went for Night Slash. All right. Now, here's my next option. Do I heal and let Haas get hit with, like, a drill peck or some other flying attack? Or try to let Haas handle it? I'm going to try to let Haas handle this. Let's go with an Aura Sphere. I do need to heal Morton at some point, though. Come on, Haas. Come on, come on, come on. Heat Wave! Well, I'm faster. So, no matter what he does, I will get an attack. He didn't even heal. Awesome. We got Honchkrow now. Honchkrow's down. Alright. He sent Gyarados back out. God dang it! How am I supposed to beat this thing? He's gonna go with... What if he goes for Earthquake? That's good against Haas. Exxon would avoid that completely. I have to put my faith in that. If he goes with Waterfall, I just have to put my faith in Exxon then. He went with Waterfall. What else was I supposed to do? You know that if I had healed Haas, he would have went with Earthquake. Oh, it... And I'm faster, right? Yes! Yes! That is how it's done. Weavile! Okay, now we're seriously in trouble. That is the thing that killed... Purina. Now it's evolved. Let us go with... Oh my god. Majestic and Aurora are the only ones at full health right now. Majestic, I feel like, would not be a horrible idea. Except, Weavile is very strong. I feel like he could 2-hit KO Majestic. Exxon, he can 1-hit KO for sure. Especially the health he's at. Alright, here's the plan. I predict him to go for a Night Slash. We're gonna go to Aurora. Okay, now that he's gotten his Night Slash off. Now I think he's gonna go for an Ice Punch. You know what? This is not a good idea. What am I even thinking? This is not a good idea at all. Someone else is gonna die. There is nothing I can do. I was thinking to switch to an Ice Punch with Majestic and then kill him right there, but Weavile is probably faster than Majestic. And if that damage that I just see right here on Aurora, if that is how much a stab Night Slash does, Ice Punch has the same base power, I'm fairly certain. So, Ice Punch will do double that, meaning even if I heal fully right now, Weavile will kill me with either a critical hit or he'll almost kill me, making sure Aurora will only get one attack off at most. But if I kept Exxon there, either he would have died. Oh, Archer, how I wish you had a Thunderbolt. Honestly, that would have changed the outcome of this whole battle if you had killed Gyarados right there. It's not your fault that you didn't kill him. Because an Exxon wouldn't be hurt right now. Although, then again, he'd probably still get killed in one hit by Weavile. Should I have trained more before this? I don't even know what good that would have done. And you know what? Then Cyrus still has his Crobat after that. Who the heck is going to fight that? You know what? I'm going to have to put my faith in somebody. I predict an Ice Punch. Let's go with Majestic. I was right. How much does this do? Alright. See that amount? That's a double that is what Night Slash is gonna do. And that is what he's gonna use. Majestic, I'm sorry, but this is all up to you. You know why? Because I need you to be a shield right now while I full restore somebody. Wait, should I heal Morton or Hawes? That's a big question right there. Hawes I know could handle Weavile for sure. But what about Crobat? Morton could probably hit, Martin can definitely handle Crobat, but I don't know about Weavile. So who do I... We're gonna heal Hawes. We're gonna use a Hyper Potion on him. Majestic, you can survive a Night Slash. Unless he gets a critical hit or gets like a min-max damage thing. Majestic! Yes, you survived! Switching you out now! Hawes, you're up! Alright. Hawes resists all of Weavile's attacks. But guess what? He'll probably switch out. He didn't switch out. Wow, he wasn't smart this time. Come on, you can kill it. You can kill in one hit. Come on, Hawes, you can kill that thing in one hit. Yes! Critical, I don't think I needed the critical hit, but thank you anyway. Axon gained experience, Majestic gained experience, and Hawes gained experience. And Aurora gained experience! Crobat time! Alright, push me to the extreme. Can Hawes survive an attack? You know, the worst thing he'll have is like a flying attack. I feel like that would only kill me with a critical hit. So you know what? It's time to full restore Morton. Right, Morton? Would Morton really be the best choice, or should I... No, Hawes can't be. Yeah, let's use a full restore on Morton right now. Now he is fully restored. And how much is Air Slash gonna do? Oh, not that much at all. In fact, let's heal Hawes real quick before I switch out. Let's use a milk on him. Alright. You know, maybe Hawes can actually get in a couple rock climbs on him. I'm gonna try one rock climb, then we're gonna switch out. Because, look, a critical hit will kill me here, and I don't want to risk a critical hit. Alright, that didn't do that much damage, but I wasn't expecting it to. I was just hoping to get a little bit of an attack off before I switch out from Hawes. So now, let's go into Morton. Oh my gosh, Air Slash is going to flinch me like a million times. Alright, well, let's go with Surf. If he's gonna just keep going with Air Slash. Yep, flinch, told ya! Toxic, oh crap. Crap. That is not good. And I'm out of, that was my only full restore. Okay, one more hit. Just one more hit, Morton. Just one more hit. We're gonna start with a milk. And then we're going to use a full heal, and then we're going to use either another milk or a surf, depending on my damage at that point. Yep, he's going to keep going for Air Slash, so that is fine. For my poison, I'm not going to deal with that Toxic. Because if he keeps flinching me, Toxic, that damage will rack up. So we're going to use a full heal. And then most likely we're going to use another milk. Alright, yes, we're definitely gonna use another milk. I'm actually hoping he goes for Toxic this time. Oh wait, no, not milk! Hyper Potion. Milk would not have restored fully. Alright, good job, Morton. Oh, he did not go for Toxic. All right, he's going to keep going for Aeroslash. Surf! Did not flinch! Goodbye, Cyrus. You are done! You are done with killing my Pokemon. I knew I said I would get revenge on Cyrus, but he killed another one of my members. All the sacrifices you made? You killed my two electric types! Purina Archer, they're gone because of you. Don't think that you can defeat or capture that Pokemon. This bizarre world is none other than that Pokemon itself. Capturing it or defeating it will make this world disappear. Very well, do what you will. Rather than repairing world, you're going to destroy it for me. Do it. Inherit my legacy. Someone's a little upset. Cyrus is showing emotion. Oh, I thought emotions were dumb. Don't believe his lies. Not possible Pokemon can make the world disappear. The world awaited your birth, not only yours either. Pokemon with you. Everyone has a part in this world. And let's go meet Giratina. Fully healed! Thank you so much, Cynthia, but Archer is not healed. If I ever get to the point where Archer... Giratina doesn't have a move where he can switch my Pokemon, does it? I hope not. I don't think it does. Alright, so I have to either stop Giratina or catch him, but I already decided that I cannot catch him because I don't think that's fair to have a legendary in a Nuzlocke. Alright, we gotta think this through. Who should fight Giratina? I'm thinking Morton. You know what? This is ridiculous. No matter who I use, I feel like there's some flaw in the plan. Because Morton is the best guy in terms of resisting attacks, but none of his attacks will do a whole lot of damage to Giratina. Should I just use the Master Ball and say screw it? No, I don't want to do that. Hold on one minute. I want to look up what Giratina has. Alright, he's got, as far as I can see, he's got Shadow Force, Dragon Claw, Ancient Power, and Ominous Wind. Alright. He doesn't have Levitate, does he? Does his origin form have Levitate? It floats, doesn't it? Because if it does, then I'm not going to use Morton. Yep, it has Levitate. Darn it! I need to think this through. Alright, I've thought it through. I have my faith in Exxon. I'm not gonna say another word. Here we go, guys. Dun, dun, dun. Here we go. I know this video is kind of long now, but this is kind of like the climax of the story. I want it to be one big episode. Dun, dun, dun. Giratina. He's quietly eyeing Michael. Oh, I'm going to walk away now. I'm just kidding. All right. Here we go. Here's why I decided Exxon. Shadow Force is a two-turn move. If I see him charging up for Shadow Force, I'll switch out. Let's start off with a Confuse Ray. I knew that would come in handy. Unless, of course, he never hits himself. Yes! Alright, it's been helpful already. Shadow Ball! Exxon, how does it feel fighting the legendary Pokemon Giratina? Ooh! 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 That did a lot of damage! Oh my god, we got this all set, guys. That was kind of anticlimactic, to be honest. Bye, Giratina. Wow, you made that look so easy, Exxon. See, told you I had a faith in Exxon. And you guys were scared. Wow. That was kind of anticlimactic, but honestly, guys, I've never found battles against the legendary Pokemon of the version, like, you know, Giratina, the Elgin Pelkey of Diamond Pearl, Reshiram, Zekrom of Black and White, and Kyurem different forms in Black 2 and White 2. I've never found those battles climactic, ever. So, I don't know. It's not surprising to me that that was such a quick and easy battle, but whatever. Does that make it impossible for me to create a new world? Even if I made new red change, the new world can't be made. Why? What compels you to protect these two worlds? It's spirit, a vague and incomplete thing, so important to you? The places we are born, the time we spend living, the languages we speak, we're all different. But the presence of Pokemon unites us. We share our lives with Pokemon, and our happiness grows as we all become greater than we were alone. That is why we can battle and trade with anyone we choose. Silence! Enough of your blathering! That's how you justify spirit as something worthwhile? That is merely humans hoping, deluding themselves that they are happy and safe. The emotions roiling inside, rage, hatred, frustration, these ugly emotions arise because of my own incomplete spirit. Enough. We will never see eye to eye. This I promise you. I will break the secrets of the world. With that knowledge, I will create my complete and perfect world. One day you will awake into the world of my creation. A world without spirit. Okay, you keep thinking that. Since there is sadness, we can feel joy. When there's anger, compassion is born. That's the one quote of Cynthia's that I actually like. June is written in legend as being on the other side of the world. It stands as a link to the other side. There's a portal. Will you leap into the portal? Yes. And? Where the heck are we? It's the send-off spring. It's said to somehow lead to the great beyond, and Giratina was said to live in a world of the opposite side of ours. Oh, I'm sorry. It's very rude of me. Michael, you're incredible. You're a fantastic trainer. Let me say this on behalf of all of Sinnoh. Thank you. Oh, you have to go tell Russ Rowan. He was very worried about you. You should visit him at his lab. Yeah, we'll do that next time. Thank you all for watching this episode, and I hope you all look forward to the next episode. See y'all next time, and of course, rock on.